Let's start our tutorial. And as usual in this tutorial, I want to share with you some thoughts that came to my mind while practicing this piece. And the main one was, if you want to train your finger muscles at your best, play chords on piano, voicing some lines. So this prelude is a great exercise for your left hand technique. So I'm gonna go through every step I made on this piece, making some comments about every principle I applied while practicing. The steps that I took and the ones you would use if you practice by the piano assisting this piece are fingering, position change, pedal, sound movement, wrist and elbow movements, intonation, weight, harmony, dynamics and voicing, musical speech, phrasing, musical image, musical form, time. That's been said, now on to the tips and insights about this piece. Let's start with the very simple ones. So when you... okay, first of all, the fingering, don't have to explain because you can find them on the screen. Maybe I will also include PDF down below so you can download if you're interested. So the fingering are clear here. I think also just one phrase about the pedal. So of course you would use harmonic pedal, changing it on every chord. Now you would sometimes need to use a technical pedal to connect the sounds that better don't connect with your fingers. I will tell you one thing. Sometimes people say you have to connect nose with fingers. You have to connect nose with your ears, not with your fingers. And if it's better for you to just, you know, let go the note and just shift your hand instead of stretching your hand and bringing some tension that will prevent you from conveying what you actually want to express, then just use your pedal. Like in this place, for example. I'm not stretching it like this because that's not comfortable. This is much more free. So use your ears, use your... In other words, more ears, it's like more abstract, you know. Use your intonation, use your imagination to connect notes, and use your pedal. Okay, so let's go to the some technical thing. So when you play your left hand, it's all about balancing, you know, how to control the evenness in hands, evenness in fingers, and playing still soft. So keeping some distance between your torso and left hand elbow helps to control and balance chords a bit. So what I mean is sometimes you play and you keep your, most probably, you're gonna keep your elbow over here. Somehow, if you just make this angle, have some room, it's easy to balance thumb. I don't know, it just helps. Now, when you make this angle, you will find that over here in the wrist, you will have not pretty angle here. It doesn't feel that easy. So for the sake of feeling a little bit better here, you can just shift yourself to the right. And let's say you sit not in front of the middle C now, but in front of G. That's actually how I sit when I play this piece. And that's what you do. Just shift yourself to the right to keep elbow here. And you see this angle here that previously was more, now it's less here. Still your elbow is there.